If you're the Fed, I think that you're trying to weigh two different elements of this jobs report. How much is trade related and how much is stuff that would be like causing a problem even if the trade war wasn't an issue? I think it's a little bit, troubling that there's a lot of weakness outside of manufacturing. For example, construction, very anemic. It's, in fact, very disturbing that despite the big drop in mortgage rates since the Fed pivoted, you haven't seen much pickup in housing. So I think that means that even if there's sort of like a clarification of the trade war clouds at the end of this month, July does increasingly look like a good time for them to reverse the cycle.
Yeah, Rebecca, is that your view? I mean, it's interesting that we can have a lot of the other data holding up well, you know, the unemployment rate being so low, the non-manufacturing survey holding up decently. Do you see this slowdown and this need for urgent rate cuts?
Well, the manufacturing sector is clearly slowing down a lot, but given what Greg just said, mortgage rates low, the consumer's doing well, and unemployment rates low, and that's the biggest chunk of the economy. It's difficult for me to see, with a high probability, the Fed needing or wanting to cut as quickly as July until they have a little more clarity on what's happening with trade, a little more clarity on what's happening with the economy. We know that core PCE, the Fed's preferred inflation measure, is down below target at around 1.6%. But most of the Fed inflation measures are near or at target, some even above. And so it's difficult for me to see the Fed feeling really strongly about a rate cut quickly until it has a few more data points. We all know these payroll numbers can be incredibly volatile month to month and get revised a lot, too.
Yeah, exactly. And, Paul, that's why I'm surprised that this Fed would even open the door towards a rate cut that you, if I'm reading this correctly, also think is possible or likely come July. Don't we need a few more months of data to figure out exactly what's going on?
I don't think we do, for a very simple reason, which is for the last decade, the Fed has missed its inflation target on the downside. For 10 years, we've been waiting to get to north of 2% for inflation, and they haven't done it, notwithstanding the incredibly low unemployment rate. So I think the presumption has to be that the Fed will be easing, and the only issue is how they configure the rhetoric and the timing and so forth. But July looks good for me.
But it's frustrating to me, and Greg, I'm curious what you think about this, that the Fed seems to only talk about rate hikes or rate cuts through the lens of economic speed-ups and slowdowns. Why aren't they just saying, hey, that aside, we're focused on inflation, and to Paul's point, it's been low and it's been missing. You know, why is it that we need it to be one side of the boat or the other in terms of the expansion?
Well, I mean, it's a great question, but they actually are looking at both things together. And indeed, one of the reasons that they did not feel the fact that they were missing on inflation for the last few months was a good reason to cut was because growth was doing so well. The economy was growing 2.5 to 3%, which is well above potential, and the unemployment rate was dropping, which tells them that the economy is running out of spare room. What's changing now is you still have the inflation below target, so that's there as a reason to cut. You probably no longer can say the economy is growing above trend. It's at best growing at trend, and we might see some data points that suggest it's growing below trend, by which I mean below 2%. So now they've kind of lost that other reason to stay their hand.
Right, but for how